I believe that when we educate others and reinforce our shared humanity, we can do away with much of the ignorance, bigotry, and hatred that plagues us as a society. While this is much easier said than done, this goal is well worth the work it entails. Thank you.
Thousands of people entered, and his message was chosen as the winner of the 11th annual Stop the Hate contest. Sam, now he phonetically spelled this for me, Ogunntoyibo, did I get it right? Yes. He is a senior at Solon High School, and he has a very powerful message, as you just heard about racism. So welcome. And congratulations. So for your scholarship, and you are going to, breaking news,
Yale University.
Congratulations. That is awesome.
Thank you.
So I want to talk a little bit about your speech, which we're going to have on Fox8.com. You have to watch the whole thing. It is so empowering. Talk a little bit about some of the life struggles that you went through. Specifically, you had an incident at a store.
Yeah. Well, the place where I work, we had a customer. He bought something for a dollar, gave me five, and obviously you give $4 and change, right? Mm-hmm. It's easy math, right? But he counted it out really slowly and kind of insinuated that I somehow didn't know how to make change for that. And it's kind of a small incident, but it just reflects a larger theme of making assumptions and belittling people, not only with your words, which, I mean, he used his words there, but with your actions and with the way you show body language. Mm-hmm. So that was just one incident that I really felt the need to write about because it reflects what a lot of people who look like me and who don't look like me experience on a daily basis.
And you even talk about feeling powerless too.
Exactly.
And was this in school a lot?
In school, oftentimes I can feel powerless because, I mean, I'm a minority, mm-hmm. I'm outnumbered, but it's really important to understand that you really aren't alone and that your words have power and your story has power.
You also talk in the speech about how you guys raised money for the Ohio Innocence Project, which is amazing. That was through the school. Talk a little bit about that.
All right, so I work with my school's mock trial team, mm-hmm. and we have a student who met a former convict who was freed through the Ohio Innocence Project, who had been unjustly imprisoned for years and years. And when I heard that story and I talked to our advisor, Mr. Rivera, we had an idea to have a fundraiser for that because it's really important to understand that our justice system needs to have justice be a priority, and some people get trampled under that. And just to be able to help an organization that seeks to mitigate some of those negative effects is just really important.
One of your goals is also to find common ground and educate others. Are mm-hmm. schools doing that? Where does it seem to be falling through the cracks?
I feel like a lot of the programs that we have in place right now kind of not really go over kids' heads as in being more complicated than kids mm-hmm. can understand, but it just doesn't reach out to what the experience of an average high schooler is. Mm-hmm. An average high schooler isn't going to be like someone in some instructional video. I mean, it's a different experience. They understand more than a lot of people let on. Mm-hmm. And I think it needs to be through the voice of someone who's like them, who can relate to them.
Right.
A student.
We're looking at pictures of your wonderful family. You have a couple siblings?
Yes.
And so what do they think of you? I know your proud mom is sitting here looking at us right now, and she ought to be very, very proud of her son.
Thank you. We're pretty close. I'm pretty close to my older sister. Uh-huh. She's in college right now. And my little sister, I don't know if she's watching this right now, but she'll see it.
She will. Yeah. And congratulations. Look at that check. $40,000 to go to Yale. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And so I was reading up on you before you got here, and apparently people are saying that you may be president someday.
I don't know.
You think so? I think you could do it.
Maybe.
What is your goals after you graduate from Yale?
I was hoping to go to medical school.
Okay.
But I still don't know. I also want to get a degree in comparative literature along with neuroscience. So I don't know. I just want to keep my options open.
You're an amazing young man. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Can I shake your hand?
Yes.
For when you're president someday? Don't forget us.
Thank you.
Thanks, Sam. Thank you for coming in. He's on
Thank
spring
you.
Break, too. So good luck with everything. And Yale, senior year.